will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here to take.
Beloved, I thank God that you have continued with me. I know that these words have been challenging and in your face. And some will say dogmatic, some will say extreme. No, beloved, it's the word of the living God. The Bible says that the time will come when we shall not be able to endure sound doctrine. It will be so offensive, it will be so difficult to handle. But we will continue to preach the unadulterated word of God until Jesus comes for us. Hallelujah. Remember, we are studying 1 Peter chapter 1. He says, we are not redeemed with corruptible things, verse 18, such as silver and gold from our vain conversations received by tradition from our fathers, but with the precious blood of Christ, with the precious blood of Christ, with the precious blood of Christ. Beloved, is that blood precious? Have you thought about that blood lately? How much it cost? That song says, I'll never know how much it cost to see my sin upon that cross, upon that tree. You see? The precious blood of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. As of a lamb without blemish. That's why I say the greatest thing the Lord did for us was to arrive at the cross sinless. For 33 years, I never sinned one time. It's tremendous. As of a lamb without blemish and without spot, who verily was foreordained, listen to this, before the foundation of the world. How can God plan your salvation and your neighbor's salvation before he even started creating this earth, before the foundation of the world? And you're going to make light of it? And you're going to think that there is another way to get this done? And you're going to think that it's a light matter that you can allow so-called friends to continue in sin and believe that God will hold you guiltless for not preaching the gospel? So the Lamb was slain before the foundation of the world. He was ordained. But watch this, but was only manifest in these last times, 2,000 years ago. But this happened before the foundation of the world. That meant that God knew that man will fall. And he planned this salvation and ordained it. How can you reject it? Remember Hebrews. He says, how shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation? Such a great salvation. For he says, if the words spoken by angels were steadfast, and every, remember how he said, you know, every disobedience received a just recompense of reward. How shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation? We need to be awakened by the word of God. We need to be shaken up, because we are lulled to sleep by all the satanic, humanistic preaching we've been hearing lately. You see? Beloved, the grace of God is fantastic. Everything happens by the grace of God. But remember the responsibility of grace. Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? Remember, according to Titus, that the grace that bringeth salvation has appeared to all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live our lives in this present world, holily and unblameable in his sight. Peter says, I know I've mixed up two scriptures there, but you need to understand what the unadulterated word of God is. The moment you stop appreciating the wealth, the preciousness, the greatness of the sacrifice to save you, then you're open to sin, you're open to seduction. Satan can get you back through difficulties or challenges, through economic challenges, or, you know, anything's possible. You see? He says, who was verily who verily was foreordained before the foundation of the world, but was manifest in these last times for you, for me, for every friend or so-called friend in your life, for all the religions and all the people in them of the earth. That's why we're commanded to go and preach the gospel to every creature. Doesn't matter, Muslims, Buddhists, Hindus, Sikhs, it don't matter, Baha'i faith, whoever you are, the millions and millions of gods and goddesses on the earth, which are no gods. You say, oh, what a terrible thing. You are disrespectful to other people's faith. I love them. I love them. I thank God that I was born into religion and then we found the Lord personally. But once you understand salvation, that this was God's plan before he created the earth, there's no way anything Satan has engendered afterwards will mean anything. Doesn't matter that these religions have been there for thousands of years. It doesn't matter. The truth still remains that God loved us so much, he gave his only son, that if we believe in him, we'll be saved. We'll be saved. I'm not saying disrespect the people or talk to them any kind of way. No, but we need to reason with them and share with them the truth of the gospel. Satan is at war with God and he created all these things and gave people a right, you know, to believe in their stuff. These are the traditions received by their fathers and handed down to them. I wish people can just come from the dead to tell the people the truth. They will all desert these, you know, false religions and come to the Lord our God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, whose son is the Lord Jesus Christ, who died for you and died for me. That's the gospel. That's the only true gospel. That's the only true relevant witness. Did you forget Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to God except through me. Is he not lying or telling the truth? Muslims told me, we don't read that part of the Bible, but I thought you said that Muhammad taught you to receive everybody God has sent before him. Then if you receive Jesus, then there's no need for Muhammad. Because Jesus said, I am the Father of one. I am all you need. You don't need anything else. There's no need for Muhammad or Buddha or anybody else. No. Please hear the word of the Lord, who by him do believe in God that raised him up from the dead and gave him glory, that your faith and hope might be in God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Verse Hebrews 10:26, I'm out of time. For if we sin willfully after that we have received the knowledge of the truth, there remaineth no more sacrifice for sins. For those of you preaching super grace, I'm not saying everything is by the grace of God. I believe in that. But remember, it says if we sin willfully, this is the New Testament, there's no more sacrifice for sins, but a certain fearful looking for of judgment and a fiery indignation which shall devour the adversaries. He says if you just go trafficking in sin because you have grace, he says all you're looking for is death and destruction that will devour the adversaries. Verse 29 says, of how much sort of punishment, suppose ye, shall he be thought worthy, who had trodden underfoot the Son of God, and had counted the blood of the covenant, wherewith he was sanctified an unholy thing, and had done despite unto the Spirit of grace. I wish I had time to delve into these things. My beloved, we shared our heart and we believe God that you will hear. Pass this devotional to your friends. Challenge people to awaken so that many and the valley of decision don't get left behind. Whether Jesus comes for you at death or he comes in the sky. May God help all of us believe and awaken and witness. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. We see you next week. Bye-bye. Yes, he is.